Hello, hello. New Necron Codex Day. Well, no, not day. It's about 3 weeks ago. But yeah. New Necrons battle report.
Yes, we're going to see how they play.
We are. You're taking a bunch of Catans. You're taking some big Doomstalkers. Mm-hmm. Only one unit of Warriors. I'm a little bit disappointed.
I know, yeah, but it's about seeing what the big hitters can do, really.
It is. I'm taking the Tau. We're trying a list, yeah, without big silly rubbish things. I don't know. I'm pretty scared.
I'm pretty disappointed.
Dan's got
you.
A whole bunch of new stuff. He's got Canoptic stuff. It's ridiculous. Yeah. We're going to see what happens. So it's green versus metal today. We're going to be fighting it out to try and... Enough of this Imperial nonsense, right?
Exactly,
Imperium's gone.
Boring.
Custodes versus Astra Militarum. Who wants to watch that type of thing? But yeah. Do if it's out already, because exactly. It's a pretty good game.
I mean, if not, we certainly haven't already played that at the same time.
Yeah, yeah. So, stay tuned. We're about to do some army showcases. You'll find out what we're bringing today, and then we'll get down to it. New Necrons.
Yes, new Necrons. Here we go.
Well, well. Tau 2,000 points without messing about with massive Forge World models. Let's see what we get. It's actually quite a lot of little models that we get for that. We have two commanders. One is Farsight over here, and he's going to be leading a squad of 6 Crisis Suits. The other is not a Cold Star commander, just a Crisis commander to give the reroll 1-2 hit, which is quite nice. 3 individual little units of Broadsides who are going to be holding the back line and stopping some sneaky Necron movement, hopefully, or Deep Strikes. 2 squads of Breachers, both with a little Cadre Fireblade. Neither of those are the Cadre Fireblade model because it's rubbish. But they're going to be running around in Devilfish. Just transports. They can pop out after the Devilfish has advanced. They can act normally, even though they can't move, I think. Oh, sorry, they can't advance and they can't charge, so they're going to be pretty good. Mention the Crisis Suits. Backing them up in the backfield, we have a Ghost Keel, and we have a Farsight Marksman hiding at the back who's going to be hiding at the back for most of the game. Lone Operative, Stealth, we quite like that. We have a Piranha. He's got 2 Hunter Seeker missiles. We like that a lot. And he's got drone harassment tactics, but really he's just going to be trying to score me some secondaries. We got a squad of 2 Tetras who are quite good for spotting and observing. We'll have a look at that in the game as long as they survive. Squad of stealth suits hiding over at the back, hiding for the rest of the game. And that is me. 2,000 points. Tau, let's kill some Necrons.
So here we go. Necrons, 2K24. At 2K points. It's going to be an interesting tryout of the new rules. We've got the new codex that's been released with some very different things that are going on. So I built a little, quite a versatile list just to sort of see what's happening. We're using the Canoptic Court, so it's very Cryptek and Canoptic focused, which is obviously, as you can see why, from this lovely showcase that I have barely any of the Canoptic and Cryptek models in there, but you know, it's all fun. We've got some Catans, which are being shown out for the first time on the channel. Very exciting, because they are really annoying, as I believe Will just found out on a tournament recently. So we can maybe plot them on objectives. Well, it's good to do that. I won't do that, because they're good for killing things. Anyway, what we've got today, we've got 2 units of Scarabs. We've got 20 Necron Warriors being led by an Overlord with a reanimation orb and an incorrectly based Cryptek Technomancer. But I am using him because he's the kill team model. He's very cool and, you know, he'll have to forgive me for that one. This is just a one-time thing. We've also got another debutant. We've got Illuminor Zarias, who is quite a cool little unit to use in this. He's going to be a fun character. We've got the Scorpec Destroyers and the Scorpec Lord, who are going to be punching Will in the face. We've got the Immortals being led by an Overlord with a Tachyon Arrow and a Plasmancer. So these ones are correctly based, so it's all right. You can see the difference between the base size. Real shame that they didn't give a conversion kick, because that's a very nice model for the Technomancer. Anyway, right at the end, we've got my heavy blasters at the back. We've got the Canoptic Doomstalkers, which are going to really benefit from those reroll ones. We've got the Locust Heavy Destroyers, which are really nasty units. And I've got a Reanimator, who's going to be hopefully keeping them all quite healthy. A couple of cool little gotchas in there. So we're going to be trying out some of the new enhancements. I've got an enhancement on this Plasmancer, which gives his whole unit infiltrators, which is quite cool. And this Technomancer is going to have one I'll reveal in the game, which would be quite fun for Will to see. Let's go and play some Warhammer.
All right, Dan.
Well, well, well.
Welly,
well,
welly, well. Welly. There's quite a lot on the board. Should we talk through our deployment quickly before we roll off for turn one and do our scout moves?
Yes, why not? Oh, yes, our scout moves, yes.
Our scout moves. All right, Dan, what you got?
So we've tried to sort of spread out across the board a little bit to screen out all of your deep strike shenanigans. Getting used to playing proper setups on the table is...
It's a bit hard, isn't it?
It's a bit difficult.
Well, we've got Search and Destroy for our deployment. So we've got these... Hopefully we're on the way overhead, but we've got these cubes, these corners as our deployment zone with a 9-inch circle in the middle with the central objective, and then the objective is just spaced out over the rest of the board. You, though, Dan, have done a thing.
Yes, I have done a thing. We have an enhancement on my Technomancer here, who is quite tricksy indeed. So I will get the actual real name of it. It's the Dimensional Sanctum. For an extra 20 points enhancement, you can give the Cryptek model, so Cryptek's only... Infiltrators, that's one, because Lone Op would be quite broken to get.
That'd be awesome.
So, to summarise it, because he's leading a unit, the entire unit then gets Infiltrator. So,
nice.
We've got a giant blob of Necrons.
You do.
Sitting on the centre objective, just trying to be a tasty little target for you.
A tasty little morsel.
Yes. But yeah, so we spread out across. As I say, we've worked on our sort of table setups, made it a little bit more proper. However, with this... deployment zones, it sort of messed with my view of it. I don't know what your thing is, Will, because I'm so used to sort of having, like, okay, we've got cannons at the back and they can shoot things. Now they can't, so we're going to have to play about with that.
We have had some comments from some very, just very truthful, that our terrain setup looks cool but isn't necessarily a very competitive setup, right?
Which is true.
I'm saying looks cool. I don't think the comments said looks cool, but we won't hold that against them.
Yes.
It looks cool. So on our board, really, we've gone for more obscuring, and as with tournaments, the obscuring is for the footprint of the building.
Yeah.
So we've got obscuring here and here. Yeah. We've got obscuring here, 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 here and here. Yeah. And then we got a bit of light cover scattered about the board. But yes, it does make firing lines a bit more difficult. And I think that's actually the idea. And it's probably going to make it interesting. So we don't just put cannons at the back and we do move them around.
Exactly.
Which would be kind of cool.
As I say, not complaining, but it's just sort of a... It's more of a comment in terms of it completely changes the way you play the game.
It has indeed, yes.
And who would have thunk that about just simple
who
terrain?
Who would have thunk it?
But yes, so got my big cannons at the back here. They don't really have any targets. So we're going to have to move.
I know, mate.
Moving with cannons.
Outrageous, isn't it?
Yeah, outrageous, ridiculous.
Yep.
We've done the rest of it to try and screen out any shenanigans you're going to pull. We've got the Catans moved into some aggressive positions.
Very aggressive.
Very aggressive positions.
Yes.
And we've got Illuminor Zarias here to go up and support his Necron Warrior brothers.
And the Catans both half damage, don't they?
They do half damage.
And, which I don't like.
And they also have a feel no pain.
Yes. They are a bit brutal. I lost very badly in a tournament game the other day against... such a list, so I'm just going to completely ignore them this time and be well behaved. Let's see if that works. So, very nice, very nice on the Tyranids, Necron side. Tyranids, I wish they were either last week or next week, something like that.
I love my Tyranids a lot, and I've been told I have to play two armies, so
to play the Necrons because it's a new codex. Plus, we painted most of these ones for you as well, Dan.
Yeah, you did, and they are lovely. They are lovely.
You
know, I mean, just the Tyranids, you know.
Yes.
They're cool.
On the Tau side, we have a couple of Infiltrator units, so you'll be able to see right at the back, we've got a Ghost Kill over there. He's got Lone Operative. I think I measured it out, so Dan shouldn't be able to get any shots in his turn one if he goes first. He's going to hopefully go up and get that objective marker, but if I do pick up Engage All Fronts or the one where you've got to deploy Teleport Homers in the corners, he'll probably go to that turn one, which is kind of nice. Another Stealth Suit Squad over here. Hopefully we can see it and the terrain isn't in the way. They're just sitting by this objective and about to get murdered by a Catan. We've got a Piranha who is just on the line. He does have Scout 9. Idea is, if I go first, he's going to scout up this way. If I go second, he's going to go and hide. Mm. Nice.
Nice.
Three units of broadsides hiding over here, all behind the obscuring cover, so Dan shouldn't be able to get any shots off turn one, which is kind of nice. If I don't go first, if I do go first, I can move them up. I'll lose heavy. That's okay. Devilfish, Fish of Fury with a Breacher Squad and a Cadre Fireblade hiding here. Another one hiding over here. Two little Tetras hiding here. And then my Farsight Marksman, because he's got Lone Op, is probably going to sit there for the rest of the game.
Boo.
Yes, we love it. off the board, because there's not that much on the board. Obviously, the units that are in the Devilfish are hiding out, so we don't... Well, because otherwise it won't fit. Two units of Crisis Suits, one with Farsight, one with the Crisis Commander. Very important role that we have to do now, Daniel.
Oh, yes. And I will use a Tau dice to antagonise you.
That's rude. So have we got Dice Cam up and running? Thank you. Go on, then, Dan.
3, 2, 1. Oh, dear.
Yes. That means...
that, of course.
All right. Looks like we're going first.
Of course the tower dice.
This is why you don't use the tower dice, Daniel. Just to call out, secret intel is our mission rule. So we do get to draw 3 secondaries at the beginning of the turn and discard one of them. And sites of power for our primary mission. I don't like this one. This is 3 victory points for each objective marker you control, but an additional 3 if you have them empowered. At the end of your command phase, you empower all of the objective markers that you're on that have a character model on them. And then you get an additional 3 victory points for that. In the 5th, it's the usual end of turn for the second player, start of turn for the first player. So you are at an advantage for your last turn if you've got enough stuff left on the board.
Yes, true.
Which we're going to find out. This is either I'm really excited, Dan, to see what the Necrons can do.
Yeah, the first turn Tau, I'm always scared of because you get those crisis suits on the board.
No, they can't come down turn one.
Well,
turn two they can. And we'll see where we are by turn two. So a quick scout move then, and then we'll go into my command phase. So 9 inches, scout on the piranha who's going to... he's going to come over this way. He's going to try and reinforce his mates over there and we'll be able to do something either over here if we need to or over here if we need to. Shall we, Daniel, see what secondaries we're going to pick up in the tap?
Well, let's see what secondaries you're picking up.
I think these have been shuffled since our last game, I hope.
I believe so.
You know how good my shuffling is? This will be exactly the same as before. So we're going to pick up 3. Capture enemy outpost, area denial, and overwhelming force. I don't like any of these. So capture enemy outpost, if I control one or more objective markers in your opponent's deployments, only score 8 victory points. Pants.
New.
No. Area denial. If one or more of your units are wholly within 6 of the centre of the battlefield and there's no enemy units within 6, then you score 5 victory points. Or if at the end of your turn there are one or more enemy units wholly within 6 and there are no enemy units within 3 of the centre of the battlefield, you score 3 victory points. That good. One's tricky as well.
Good luck.
Yep, thank you. And then overwhelming force, I need to destroy enemy units in range of an objective marker, of which there are 2. It looks like we're going to have quite an aggressive turn one. Ooh. We're going to double down.
We're
discarding Capture Enemy Outpost, and we're going for Area Denial and Overwhelming Force, and we're going to try and get the center of the board.
Get rid of that objective.
Discarding this one, this is going to be a very interesting turn. So we are going to get 1 CP at the start of my turn. What's this, Daniel?
Just checking. Oh, so we probably should go over the Illuminor Zarias' ability, which hopefully is going to support them a little bit.
Okay.
I just was checking. So the only issue is he needs to be within 3, not 6.
And he is not within 3, Daniel.
Yet. Which is why I was hoping for turn 1.
Yes. Too bad, because of the way that the deployment zone was, Dan could infiltrate within the centre of the battlefield, but more than 9 inches away from my deployment zone, so he was a bit stuffed. Let's see if we can take on a big squad of Necron Warriors.
Go for it.
I know. I'm going to do some movement, and then we're going to be right back and see where we end up. This could be interesting. All right, Daniel, we've had a movement phase and quite a lot has changed.
Yes.
Obviously, by going very aggressive turn one, I had to go very aggressive turn one.
Mm.
Don't like it. It's not the way the tower work, but you forced me into Ancorneur. So
yes.
Let's see what we can do.
Exactly.
Jumping to the overhead very quickly. Tetras came over here.
Mm-hmm.
Just a couple of units that they could spot for or observe for, which is very nice. Obviously, the lone op marksman stayed where he was because he loves it. We've got 2 broadsides that came over here. With some lines down here, which could be quite nice. 1 broadside who popped over here. I think his line really is only to those Doomstalkers over there. The Devilfishes ran up, and they can advance and disembark. The 2 Breacher squads popped out of there. Daniel declared an Overwatch at that point for this squad over here, so we will let him do that in a second. The Ghost Kill in the back corner just moved up a little bit, so he's within 3 of that objective. Tried to measure it so Dan can't get any sneaky charges or within 12 to shoot me. Very lastly, Piranha moved over here to get a couple of spotting targets. He's got a Hunter Seeker. He's going to use it. Of course he is. And the Stealth Squad over here just moved up a tiny bit to be able to get a spot over there as well if they need to.
Yeah.
Daniel, do you want to overwatch me?
Oh, yes, I do.
What's overwatching, Dan?
What's overwatching? Well,
yes.
Funnily enough, this giant blob of Necrons.
Yes, funny that.
So that at least they get 1 shot off.
Well... yeah, so at this point, I either pop a CP to go to grab... What's your AP on your guns here?
So they have Gorse Reapers.
Yep.
Short range, 2 shots each.
Oh, dear.
Quite nasty. -1 AP.
-1 AP.
Would be -2 if he was in range. Sadly, no.
It would. So, question is, I think I pop my CP here for Go to Ground to get the benefit of cover. And what else does Go to Ground do, Dan?
What else does Go to Ground do? I don't know.
That's okay. Yes. You start rolling some dice and I'll figure that one out.
I never go to ground. Not a coward.
No, not a coward, obviously.
Considering you have gone to ground, let me just quickly check something.
I get six up in Vault Save and I have the benefit of cover.
One object.
Six up in Vault Save doesn't do anything.
Yes. Is this unit within range of that objective marker?
Yes.
They are. Okay. So, I'm going to pop a CP.
Okay.
I'm going all out turn one.
Yeah.
Not even, sorry, turn zero technically for me, to use Solar Pulse. Solar Pulse allows me to ignore cover upon you going to ground.
Okay.
In response to that.
Okay.
So, this Cryptek model here has given this unit ignoring cover.
Lovely.
Well, his own unit. So let's start rolling some dice. So these are lethal hits. We'll start with the warriors themselves. They have two shots.
Oh, they were lethals as well.
Yes.
Eek.
Eek, eek, eek.
Eek.
We will get 20 dice and roll it twice. Ugh. Riveting viewing always. Picking out lots and lots of dice. Okay. Volley number one. Sixes.
One.
Good.
Next lethal. Volley. I like this, but it is a lethal, so it's gone straight through.
Gone straight through, yes. So no ignoring of cover. No, so no cover, I mean. Can we have some more sixes? Yeah.
So four in total.
Four in total.
And these will be at minus one, ignoring cover, so I will have a five up save on these.
Correct.
Each one, dead breacher. I'll reroll that one.
Yep. Lucky. Three dead breaches.
Three dead breaches.
Last but not least, we also have the Technomancer, who has a Staff of Light, and it has changed, so forgive me checking it to make sure I know what it does. Staff of Light, just three shots. Sixes. Minus two. Nothing.
All right, that was... Oh, Dan, you already spent a CP on Overwatch. So
I
you
did,
couldn't
so
spent
I couldn't
a CP
have spent
on
the
cover.
On the...
Wouldn't have made any difference
yes.
because I didn't roll any fours.
No, you didn't roll any fours, so it's fine. But
there you go.
Sorry.
Meant to have a Servo Skull, you know, calling out that type of thing. But... Is he painting?
Where's Rules Lawyer Chris when you need him?
There you go. He's painting in the corner. all right, man. Am I allowed to do some shooting now? Is that right?
Yeah, go on.
Okay, that was my movement phase. Now we've got to do some shooting and we've got to declare my observers and my spotters.
Yes.
What I just read on my Breacher Squad thing, which is kind of nice, I think if I make a ranged attack that targets an enemy unit within range of an objective marker, I can re-roll the wound rolls,
ooh.
Which is rather nice.
Yes.
So
basically
this,
you re-roll everything.
Well, a little. We'll see. So yeah. This unit here of the stealth suits are going to guide this unit of Breachers, the 10-man squad of Breachers, and they'll be my opponent.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we're hitting on twos at that point, and we are rerolling wounds,
yes.
which is rather nice. I think what will happen is... now we've made it a bit tricky, haven't we?
Mm.
This squad of Tetras will spot that Doomstalker for that broadside, so I'm rerolling my hits,
yes,
which is rather nice. This Piranha... I guess at this point we'll spot this unit for that squad of Breachers.
Mm-hmm.
This Devilfish will spot that unit of Angry Murder Crabs
yep.
for that broadside.
Mm-hmm.
And that Devilfish will spot that... he's got low not because he's close.
Yep.
So it will... I think at that point we don't spot anymore.
Mm.
I think at that point we don't spot anymore.
Interessant.
Interessant indeed. I mean, the other option would be targeting there for the ghost kill, but I do kind of want to shoot into this
mm-hmm.
combat, even though it's not that many shots. Have to excuse us. Might have heard that. That's the airbrush corner in the studio. Hopefully it wasn't Christopher. Cool. And let's do some shooting, man.
Go for it.
Let's start off with the stuff that can't shoot anything else.
Yeah.
So let's start off with Mr. Broadside. Mr. Broadside, who will shoot his Hunter Seeker course. I think he can only take one. I think I got corrected on this the other day. He can take one. He'll shoot his Hunter Seeker and he'll shoot his heavy rail rifle into that Canoptic Doomstalker.
Yes.
Hunter Killer.
Hunter Killer.
We are going to hit you on a three because we are spotted.
Ooh, you do hit.
Okay, and Hunter Killer is... Sorry, it's not Hunter Killer, it's just a Seeker. Strength 14 against?
It's T more than 7, so 3s.
On the Doomstalkers?
On Doomstalkers, yes.
That does wound. That is at minus 3.
Minus 3? Didn't expect him to be shot at. Unbelievable. 4 up in Volm.
D6 plus 1 damage. Damage. How much has he got left?
He has 6.
Okay, we've got 2 shots from the heavy rail rifle. Hit you on 3s. Okay, that's all right. Strength, 12.
T's, 8.
Oh, one gone. That is 1 dev wounds, Dan. Ooh, that is 1 dev wounds for D6 plus 1 damage.
So roll that, see if I need to roll a save.
Oh, just 2.
We have a chance.
Okay, that's him shot.
Oh, you missed with the other one?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, yeah.
Fabulous.
Yeah, we're hitting on threes, not twos.
Yeah.
Okay, that's all right.
He's alive.
That's all right, he's alive. We don't care. Okay. Next up then, we're going to keep the broadsides in case we need to shoot into that squad of warriors. Let's go with this squad of...
7.
7 and the Cadre Fireblade Breachers. We're going to roll a lot of dice now for probably both Breacher squads and then start doing some save rolls on camera because otherwise this may take 7 hours and we're going to save you from that.
Exactly.
So bear with us. It's going to be Breacher Squad 1 and then Breacher Squad 2. We'll come back with how many saves Daniel has to do.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
All right, let's go. Okay. Sorry, Daniel. you missed that, and I am glad you missed that because there was an awful lot of dice to roll. There was 30 shots from one squad plus the Cadre Fireblade, 21 shots from the other. Hitting on twos because we get the plus one ballistic skill, rerolling all of our wounds because you're near range with an objective marker, and the face that Daniel is pulling is about how that went.
It hurt.
We killed 20 Necrons.
Only the Breachers.
Just the Breachers. That was quite fun.
Yes.
Imagine if I was getting my 2 exploding sixes.
Imagine.
In turn 3 onwards. That would have been quite tasty, wouldn't it? Mm. Now they are going to die in a stiff breeze, but... You know.
I don't have a stiff breeze.
You have a lot of stiff breezes, Daniel. Don't sell yourself short. Daniel, stiff breeze, man. But we got a little bit of other shooting to do.
Yes.
And luckily that is scoring me over 1v4s and it's getting me the little score for area denial, which is quite exciting. Let's go with the piranha. Mm. Not a suicide piranha today, just a piranha.
He isn't
in range of anyone with his little melter gun, but he does have a seeker missile, which is very exciting. I'm just checking he doesn't have 2. That would be nice, wouldn't it? He has 2 Seeker missiles.
Of course he does.
He's going to shoot both of them into your... I did manage to wound... The Lord
Overlord.
Here. The Overlord over here. He's down on 5 wounds. We're going to shoot 2 Hunter Seeker missiles into him.
Fours
indeed. Dan, sixes don't explode because we're not in that turn yet.
Oh, no.
I know. Pardon me, viewers. Just got to tidy up the carnage and destruction of the Breacher Squad. 2 shots, Daniel. We're going to hit you on 4s. Oh, he's angry. This is strength.
So it'll be 2s.
14. Daniel. Daniel.
Goes to my envelope.
Daniel.
Good.
Oh.
Oh, no.
Come on, Dan.
Oh.
Okay, 1 save, 1 failed. D6 plus 1 damage, and you've got 5 wounds left. Damn it. He's on 2 wounds. Might have to charge him with some breaches. They'll do the job.
Yes.
Nope. Okay. That makes the rest of my shooting a bit annoying. What we're going to do is we're going to shoot this broadside into that unit over there that he's been spotted for.
Oh, the Scorpex?
The angry Scorpex with his rail rifle, his Seeker missile. He's going to go into this guy.
Overlord, yeah.
Okay. 2 shots from the rail rifle.
Yep.
These will be hitting you on 3s, but I'm going to be hitting on 5s for my Seeker missile.
Yes.
Because minus 1, because I'm shooting someone I wasn't spotted into. Mm-hmm. The rail rifle. Hits 2 times. Wins 2 times.
Yep.
That's at minus a decent chunk. Dan, do you have a invul? It's at minus 4.
On the law.
Into the...
destroyers.
Yes.
New invul there.
Okay. Minus 4, 2d6 plus 1. We've got to roll these one at a time.
Yep.
First one kills a dude.
Yes.
Second one,
kill the dude.
All right, we got a seeker missile down on a 5.
Okay.
This one's important. No, good. Well done, chap. This one is going to shoot. I just really want to kill the Overlord, Dan. But there's nothing else that can shoot him.
Oh, no.
Do we shoot a rail rifle into him? Is that wise? No, we'll do the same split as before. Hunter Seeker, twin rail rifle. Hunter Seeker.
Into the Overlord.
On a 5. Let's go. On a 2. I'm not even going to look. I'm going to do a Chris. 6. He's not even paying attention. If he did, that's Dev Wayne's, Dan.
Oh, yeah. So how many? Oh, yes, D6 plus 1. For 2.
Yes. Woof. That was exciting. That's another unit that was in range of an objective marker.
And now you score all 5.
Yeah. No, because you're still within 6 with that dude.
Okay.
But that's quite exciting. Yes. And then the twin rail rifle into the destroyers.
Mm-hmm.
Hit you
none of the times.
Okay. Have we got anything left to shoot down? These dudes, I mean, there's no point in shooting into this stupid thing.
Ooh.
It's just the worst. We'll try. We've got 2 burst cannons. Ooh. We're going to be on 5s because we're not shooting at the guy we spotted. We might as well.
3 of the times.
All right, boys. It's going to be strength 4, so probably 6s to wound. I'm assuming you're T8.
At least, yeah.
Nothing. It doesn't, unless he's T7, but even then it wouldn't have mattered.
T11.
Okay.
So it's 7.
Neither of those things. I don't know if these little piranhas, sorry, the Tetras have anything to shoot. So my last thing to shoot, if that's the case, would be they do have 30-inch, 1 pulse rifle shot each. Very exciting. Hit on 4, strength 5, no AP. 1. Damage.
Now, I don't think they can actually
shoot. No, there's no point. Let's shoot with the... Oh, did I shoot his big guns into there?
Yes.
And I didn't do anything.
You
from
didn't,
this one.
You missed with both of them.
Whiff. Okay. No, I haven't shot my rail rifle yet.
You did. You rolled a 2 and a 1.
Okay. Good. And then over there, let's shoot with the ghost keel. He'll shoot into there. He'll go hazardous. Because why wouldn't you?
Why wouldn't you go hazardous?
Why wouldn't you go hazardous? So the ghost keel has 36 in his iron raker. He's got 6 shots. He's going to hit you down on 4s. That's boogie. All right, he's not that boogieing. I wish I was guided. I wish I had a turn when... Oh, well, strength 8.
Strength 8 against who?
The
Scorpex. Yes, 3s.
Okay, just 1 wound. This is at minus 2, and it's 3 damage if it goes through. Pop. Mm. All right, hazardous check. He's all right.
He's okay.
So, I think, Daniel, that's my turn. I'm not charging because I'm not a fool.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I am, but that wouldn't be very wise. So, that's my turn, dude. Area denial. I think we're still only getting 3 VP because I'm pretty sure you're within 6 of the center. Yes, you are. So, 3 victory points for area denial, but I'm glad I managed to score that.
Mm-hmm.
And then overwhelming force. We did kill 2 units, so we're going to get 5 victory points.
Nice.
Very nice. Mm. Crikey. Crikey. Got very hot and sweaty in the studio all of a sudden.
Oh, yes.
Daniel, Necrons turn 1.
Mm. Well, yes, let's see what happens.
Do you want to do
let's get some secondaries.
Let's get some secondaries. 3 secondaries, Dan.
3 secondaries. Capture any outposts.
Okay.
Not happening, I don't think. No, not happening, so we'll discard that one. Tempting target, pick me an objective marker.
That's tempting?
Yes.
I don't think you can get to that one, so I might say that one.
Yeah. And engage on all fronts.
That you can do.
I actually don't think I can.
With a bit of movement, you can get 3 corners.
Oh, yes, yes.
This is tempting. Cool. We're both getting a CP.
Mm-hmm.
Don't think there's any way for us to get more than 1.
No.
Do you want to do me a battle shock on that... Doomstalker.
Oh, is that at the end of my command phase?
That's...
Because at what point is that in the end of my command phase?
That's at the start of your command phase. Rules lawyer Chris.
We need rules lawyer because I get reanimation protocols, which then mean he's not under half strength.
That's very true. At what point are we rolling Battleshock? At the start of the command phase or at the start of the command phase, right?
Start.
Yeah, start.
Cool.
He fails.
I don't think it really matters, but then I'll roll my reanimation.
So can he reanimate if he's battle shocked?
Yes, it's not a thing.
Cool. No, I know it's not a strat, but it might say...
Nope.
Okay. All right.
There you go. Gets 5 wounds back.
Almost like we didn't do any damage.
Ha.
Okay.
Cool. Right.
What's your game plan, Dan, for this turn?
I actually don't think I have one. I've got to be honest.
You still got a unit off the board.
Yeah, but they don't turn up till the next turn.
Yep.
None of these things really move.
No.
And I can't really shoot anything.
Well, let's find out what happens.
It's all really good.
It's all good. Yes. Let's go. Movement phase, Necrons, go.
Cool. All right. We have, you know, we've tried to do a couple things.
Yeah.
He's not as cool anymore because he can't really do any special enhancements.
But can he kill a squad of breaches?
We're about to find out. Let's see. I don't know if there's enough shots, but we'll find out. We've sort of advanced. We've moved the Technomancer back to maybe do a bit of... healing back over here eventually. We've moved these guys up so they can get a bead on some of the units that you have.
Venerable one.
Venerable
bead.
Venerable, yes. we've moved our scarabs in here to try and score engage on all fronts, along with advancing the Catan Shard and the Scorpec Lord to try and next turn get something at the Ghost Keel. And yes, that's what we got. So we have got some shooting to do, I guess.
Yes.
So let's start with the things that make sense. So we're going to use Illuminor Zarias using his Eldritch Lance, which has a range of 36 inches.
Crikey.
Where is he going to shoot? Let's have a think. He's actually, because it's quite a nasty little weapon... He's not going to shoot at the piranha,
breaches.
He's going to shoot at that broadside over there. And we're going to take a bit of a gamble.
Okay. All right.
So, 3 shots.
Yeah.
Hitting you on 3s.
Okay.
Hit you 2 of the times.
He does hit you 2 of the times. Okay. What's his strength?
These are strength 9, so he'll be wounding on 3s, I believe.
3s indeed.
Ooh, that's one that doesn't. That's 2.
That doesn't.
That's good. Good, 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 good. Then we've just moved the Catan Shard of the...
Of the
Nightbringer Death Leaper thing. Death Reaper. He has the Gaze of Death.
He does.
Which is 18 inches. What can he shoot with that?
I thought seasons weren't meant to fear him, though.
Nor do the wind, the sun, and the rain.
Very true. We can be like they are. Just come on, baby.
We're
going to get in trouble with YouTube copyright.
Exactly, yes. If we go any 18, further than that,
18, he can get a shot. Yep.
So he has D3 shots.
Ooh, Trez.
3. Hitting you on 2s.
Very good. The customary one.
Customary one has to be what we've done there. Strength 12, so...
2s. He's only toughness 6.
Ooh, that's both. So -2 to your armour.
Okay. We will be on a 4-up Sabre or a 4-up Invuln.
Ooh, pick which one you want to go with.
Oh dear, why?
I don't know. there's no special rules. Really.
How much damage each time?
D6 plus 3.
Cripes. Okay, they got 10 wounds each, effectively.
So we could get something here.
One at a time.
One at a time.
Saved.
He's good. And 6?
No. Oh. One goes through.
So he won't die, but he will take 7 wounds.
7 damage. Very tasty.
Very tasty from the Gaze of Death.
All right, man.
Ooh. Each enemy unit, that's quite nice. So we will find that in the fight phase. Next, shooting-wise, he can't shoot because his weapon isn't assault. These guys have moved. They have lost heavy.
Yes.
But they can still shoot you.
They can. What are they going to go for?
So they're going to go... So they are a separate unit. So we're going to start with one going into that guy.
All right.
Actually... One can't kill him anyway, so we're going to use both at the same time. Just to speed up play. Good. Oh, hang on. I think they have a reroll ones thing, or they used to. So bear with me. That was 2 ones. bear with me, because they used to have a reroll ones thing. Let's see. A wound roll of 1.
Oh, no, Daniel.
Goody gumdrops.
That's all right. That just means that your Doomstalkers are going to do the business.
Yes. So we have... 1 Doomstalker, which can only shoot that piranha over there.
The piranha?
So...
Leave him alone.
Actually, he technically, I think he has a...
He will have a bead on this one because he shot him before.
Yes.
So he can see him.
Exactly. He will have a bead on that.
Yeah.
He also has a bead on the Fish of Devils. Let's shoot the devil fish.
This one or that? They're this one.
Yeah.
All right. Shoot the Fish of Devils. See what happens.
For two shots.
Good.
We have two shots going at you, hitting you on... They didn't move heavy, so threes.
Lovely.
Ooh, I should remember that. Yeah, they get to reroll hits anyway. Doesn't matter, but we hit you both at the time. We have strength 14.
T9.
Threes. Good.
Uno.
One, minus three to your armor.
Okay. Six up save. Five up from a bit of cover? No, you can see...
Yeah, we can see you very clearly.
Okay. Nope.
Three damage.
Oh, okay. I was worried. I was terrified there for a second, Daniel.
They usually get more shots.
They do.
That's usually the way...
Is that what the second one's going to do?
That's what the second one's... Should he get the devil fish? Yeah, why not? He'll get the devil fish.
How much do you dislike the devil fish is the question.
I don't know. I mean, technically I should really try and go take out that broadside because then at least something has died.
We've done three so far.
We're
going to change to the camera just looking at you because I'm going to go around the corner and get some wound counter dice.
Oh, really? Yep. How many wounds has the devilfish got left?
10.
10. We're not going to kill him. Let's kill the broadside. Oh, good. There we get six shots. So seven shots in total. I'll roll these out while you get your wound counter dice.
Thank you.
Only one of these has to go at the broadside. We hit you. All but... All of the times, because you get to re-roll all wound rolls, because I'm in my deployment zone.
You're gonna kill my broadside, Dan.
I think these are twos, because he's T7.
He is T6.
T6, twos. Good, so all of those are at minus three to your armor. You have to save all
of them.
Onto
which one?
Onto
the one on three wounds.
The one on three wounds, yes.
Yeah, he might not this one.
The shots really went the wrong way around there, didn't they? With considering the targets, but let's go from there.
I mean, that was an ad... Wait, was it minus two?
Minus three.
But
he has an invuln, doesn't he?
No, not only he gets mortal wounds. He does have a little bit of cover there, Dan. You know what that means?
Does he have cover from this guy?
Can you see all of his base?
Oh, I can't see all of his base,
yeah,
no.
Yeah, we got a bit of cover. So four up saves.
So all of them save.
The plucky little broadside. Don't shake your head at me, Tom.
Right, let's charge. Have something. Exactly, yes.
All right, he doesn't have cover, he blows up.
No, it's fine, he has cover. Right. He has cover, it's fine. Let's charge with these guys.
Into my stealth suits?
Yes, they don't make it.
No.
Let's charge with the other scarabs.
Okay,
into that unit of breaches.
I am going to pop a CP for rapid embarkation.
Ah.
You can choose a different target, but now they are back in the devilfish.
Well, they're going to charge the devilfish then.
Okay. All right.
Do they make it?
On a six?
Don't think so.
They might struggle.
Being honest. But they might do.
I think you might be a bit short there, young Daniel. Oh.
Yes, you're right. Just short. Oh, well. We'll charge Illuminous Arius at the other breaches.
Yeah, they can't run away.
What?
They can't run away.
Good.
They're going to very much
so he goes
not
there.
Like this.
We're also going to charge with the Gaze of Death at them. It's going to be very much overkill, and they're not going to be able to take out all of them. But
that's
it's going to be fun.
And you've stopped me from getting that objective anymore.
Yeah. You know, there is that.
There is.
All right, so that's all I got.
Combat Tau, you ready for this? I got fight first. I've got 12 attacks each.
Really?
Strength 24, minus 5, ignores invuln save, ignore feel no pains, and doesn't allow you to half damage.
That's only on the breaches, right?
Just on the breaches.
Just
on the Cadre Fireblade.
Just on the Cadre Fireblade. That's exactly what I thought was going to be the case.
Right, who's going first?
Well, we'll chuck in the Catan Shadow of the Nightbringer first, because why not?
Yep.
We may as well give... Literally none of this really matters, because all of these attacks will kill you. but we may as well give Illuminor's Arias a go, because why not, I suppose?
Yeah, go on, see what he can do.
So we'll use the Devastating Wound, six attacks, one from the... So this is the lower number of attacks from the Nightbringer.
Okay.
So we have six attacks, hitting you on twos. Customary two ones.
You got to have it. It's just got to be done.
These are strength 14.
Yeah, it might be twos.
So that's two that go through. Minus 40 your armor.
Yeah, I think you've killed two.
Good. It's so D6 plus two damage.
Yeah, do you want to roll it?
Yes. Had to be done.
Lovely.
Right, so that's him that's attacked. Now we have Illuminor's Arias. Should have gone for the sweep attacks because I'm rolling awfully.
Yes.
But anyway, he has his first load of attacks. We'll use the impaling legs first. He has two different weapons. These do have extra attacks, so that's quite good. So he has four attacks from his impaling legs. These need to all now go through to kill your unit of... Oh, no, there's only seven in there, so...
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and the Kadro Fireblade left.
Yeah.
We do have a shield drone as well, though.
Shield drone, okay. Right. Anyway, we hit you two of the times.
Yep.
Wound you on twos because you're T3, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's two that go through it. Minus one to your armor.
Minus one?
Yeah, these are the rubbish attacks.
Ah, two five ups coming up. Nope.
Nope, two dead.
Yep.
Then we have another four attacks hitting you on threes. Customary one. Twos. Customary one. Minus three to your armor. Three damage each.
Okay.
Six up saves?
Yeah.
Is it? Or is there four up normally?
Four up normally.
Cool.
So minus two.
So no, minus three.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
So they are dead.
How much damage each?
Three.
Okay, yeah. It's two dead. Okay.
And at the end of the fight phase, after you do your attacks, I'll have something to do.
All right, we're going to pile in.
Go for it.
Hope you're OC nothing. All right, are you ready for this, Dan?
Yes.
The Breacher Squad are going to smack two of them into Illuminated Terios.
Yep.
They've got one attack each.
Yep.
They hit you on fives. Oh,
they're angry.
They're very angry. Strength three.
So sixes.
It's going to be two sixes again.
Yep.
Oh, so close. So close.
One against the Deathbringer.
One against the Deathbringer.
Or Nightbringer.
Good. And then the Kadro Fireblade.
Yep.
I hope you're ready. He's pretty angry. He has three attacks.
Ooh.
He hits you on fours.
Who's he hitting? Luminosarius.
Yeah, it's a one-on-one.
Mono, a mono. One hit.
One hit. Strength three, Dan.
So sixes.
Oh,
yep.
What,
minus?
Yep.
Minus?
Nope. Yes.
See, now...
Poked him in the eye.
The only thing that I have to fall back on is that he is quite tough and he has a feel no pain.
No, not allowed. Not allowed.
How many damage?
What? Of course. Oh. Whatever.
So, I believe that's the end of the fight phase, right?
I believe that's the end of the fight phase.
So let's see which units are within 6 inches of the Nightbringer. So obviously these guys.
Yep.
We have your Devilfish and...
Devilfish 2.
Devilfish number 2. So on a 4 up, each unit will take... on a 4 up for each unit, they will take D3 mortal wounds.
Lovely.
So they are
going to take D3.
For two.
I'll kill their dude and a shield drone.
Cool. Then Devilfish number 1 on the left. New. Devilfish number 2 on the right. New. Good. Good, good, good. So he drained life. That's all done. We are engaging all fronts to end my turn.
For three table corners.
Yep, so I get 2 VP, I think.
You get 3 VP because they're tacked to cow.
Oh, lovely.
Are you going to discard tempting target?
Yes.
I would keep it down because you can keep it and then score it next turn when you go and obliterate that.
But he will run away.
Yeah. But you can still just move and take the tempting target.
This is true, I suppose. Yes. We'll keep it. Yes.
Unless I drop down my crisis suits there. I want to give you all of the options and all of the permutations.
So, I mean...
You can discard it for a CP or you can keep it.
I think we will take the CP.
Okay. So that's it for turn one.
Yes.
Interesting. Very interesting.
Mm.
Let's start turn two.
Yes.
I've got a Battleshock here to do. Obs, which we pass.
Yep.
And I've got a Battleshock with that broadside to do, which we fail. Shame. Shame.
How many points did you get?
For the primary, Daniel or me, Tom?
Daniel, three points.
3 points, mm-hmm. But got an extra CP for discarding. So, in the primary, Dan, mm-hmm. we have to go back to the Sites of Power. So, you get 3 victory points for each objective mark you control and 3 for each site that you've empowered. I have now empowered with a character on this here objective marker. So, we are scoring 6, 9, 12 victory points this turn command. I'm assuming you're more than OC3?
Yes.
How much OC are you?
7. No, Deathbringer himself already out OCs you.
I've got OC2 each, Dan.
OC2 each for the breaches?
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
I know.
So let's find out what Luminor Zarias is. OC3, so I'm OC7 overall.
Okay, so OC2, no, unless the Kadro Fireblade is, no, he's only OC1. I just want to check something really quickly on Sight's power. Do you have to control it? Players don't use and powers all sights they control. Okay, cool. Yeah. Cool. Let's pick up some secondaries.
Yep.
And see what we need to do. Tempting target. Assassination.
Mm-hmm.
Investigate signals. Investigate signals is corners. I think there's a decent chance of me being able to do that on 3.
Yeah.
Assassination would be fun, but I'd have to go for this dude.
Well, you could go for him, or him, or him, or him.
That's true.
Or him.
Ooh, that's very true.
Just being honest and giving all
the options. That's very true. And then attempting target would be the center, most likely, because you don't want to tempt that one or that one, so you'd say here.
Mm-hmm.
What would be more fun? Trying to just go for the center, get assassinate and tempting target, or play the game properly and do investigate signals?
I still think you can get more points from assassination and tempting target.
That's true. Because
investigate signals, I think you can get maximum of 6.
Tempting target, you get 5-4. Assassination, you... Each time you kill a character, you get 4 VP. Or tactical, you get 5, but that's it. It's just 1.
Oh, you got 5 in total?
5 in total.
Yeah.
Investigate signals, you can technically score 8 if you get all 4 corners, but there's no way we can get all 4 corners.
But you will get 6 from this turn.
We could.
That's probably the best one to go for.
I think what we do is go investigate signals and assassination.
Yes. Because then guarantee there, basically.
Possibly. I mean, it means I have to shoot him, though, Dan.
Yes.
It means I have to shoot him.
I know.
So, why don't we do a bit of movement and see where we end up? There might be some more crisis suits on the board. Let's find out.
Ooh.
Turn 2, we're only going to get the exploding sixes for 1 squad of crisis suits, but we'll see if it will be enough.
Mm-hmm.
See you in a second. The jaws of the trap, Dan, are closing, hopefully.
Yes.
We're going to find out if it works.
Mm.
In the movement phase, we disembarked the noble Breacher Squad yet again to pop out over here because they like that Nightbringer and they like the idea that they're going to take him down.
I thought they would be.
It's very exciting. Yeah. These chaps, as a result, retreated out of combat, which is their right and probably the right thing for them to do. Stealth Squad over here ran back into this corner to get some investigate signals, which they're going to be doing in the shooting phase. Piranha came up to cover this objective and protect from those nasty, nasty scarabs.
Mm-hmm.
Broadside stay where they were because they got a few different lines on a few different things. Heavy will be nice here. These Tetras stayed where they were, as did the lone op. This Broadside stayed where he was. The Devilfish stayed where he was there, moved over there just so he can get some pole shots because that would be kind of funny.
Mm-hmm.
And over here, Ghost Keel ran backwards.
Yep.
Just thinking of investigating a signal. And the Crisis Squad with Exemplar of the Kaoyan came down. So they're going to be getting Exploding Sixes this turn.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, Daniel. Yes.
All right.
There's a lot to do.
Yes.
There's a lot to do.
Let's go.
So what we will do is declare which ones are investigating some signals.
Mm-hmm.
It will be... You're not eligible to shoot or declare a charge. Okay. The Ghost Keel is going to investigate a signal.
Mm-hmm.
This unit here are going to investigate a signal. So they're not going to be able to shoot. And that means they're not eligible to shoot, which means I'm not going to get...
Spotting.
Do I need spotting? Yes. Oh, no. We're not going to investigate a signal over here. We're going to investigate a signal over there.
Yeah?
These chaps are going to spot.
Who are they going to spot?
That dude for them. From this guy?
Yes.
But we'll get to that in a second.
Yes.
We'll start off with the ones we need to. We need to get some assassinate points this turn. So over here, the Tetras are going to spot the Dragon Man for the unit of Crisis Suits.
Yep.
Over here, I think this Devilfish will spot this angry Caesaror for this Broadside.
Mm-hmm.
Over here, I think this unit aren't able to shoot and they don't. They don't have assault weapons, or they do have assault weapons.
But they ran away.
And we are not able to do anything with that. Good. So, no. Don't think you can retreat and shoot with assault weapons. It's just run and shoot, right?
Yeah, just run and shoot. Yeah, running away is not the same.
So they're not going to be able to spot for anyone. Question is, do I spot with my broadsides at all? I can get a... It just limits me if I don't... I need the options, I think.
Yeah.
I think. So, yeah. Spotting here for them.
Mm-hmm.
Spotting there for them. mm-hmm. and spotting there for him. Mm-hmm. That's it. Let's start and see where we get to. Nice and easy. It's weird, Dan. I'm getting some deja vu here.
I know, yeah.
Yeah.
Let's see what this happens
I
here.
I definitely remember that he has line operative on
Luminosarius, exactly, when he's within 3 inches of another Necron unit.
Okay.
Quite a handy little thing.
It is quite a handy little thing, which means that obviously you can't shoot at him with most of the guns that you'd want to shoot at him with.
Yes.
So let's start off over here then. This broadside is going to shoot your Skorpec Lord,
ooh,
Daniel, who
okay.
doesn't have any of that nonsense.
Yes.
Two shots. He hits you ooh. One time.
Yes.
He wounds you.
One time.
Minus four.
Four up in bone. No.
Lovely.
D6 plus one.
Three.
He has some wounds left.
Good. How many wounds?
I will find out for you. He has... ooh. Four wounds left.
All right. We're gonna shoot the Farsight Marksman into him as well,
ooh.
Daniel. Three shots. It's 36, though.
Yeah, you can hit him.
I don't know, man. That's close.
Nah, 36 is ages away.
Oh, yeah, we're good. All right, 36 inches.
Mm-hmm.
It's all you need. Three shots. Hitting you on threes, because it's heavy.
Mm-hmm.
Good.
Two. Customary one.
It is precision, which is quite nice. Doesn't matter anyway.
Strength.
Five.
So fives.
Good. Yep. Very well done, everyone.
Yes.
Okay, that means we've got two more broadsides to shoot before we get onto the other nonsense.
Yes.
Let's do this broadside into Illuminator Zerberus. Two ooh. Shots. He's just within 12 inches.
Yep.
He hits you none of the times. Good. Okay. We're not doing very well on Assassinate, are we, Daniel?
No.
I mean,
you've
not so much. He's
going to go down pretty easy.
These guys to try. Yeah. I don't know. We'll see. And then we've got this broadside, who obviously can't shoot Zerberus.
Mm-hmm.
But he can shoot the Nightbringer.
He can shoot the
Nightbringer.
He's
got half your damage, isn't he?
Yes.
Don't like half damage. Those things you want to shoot with one damage attacks.
Yes.
Does he have a Feel No Pain down?
He does.
Tell me the stats of both of your chaps that are there so I can make an informed decision.
I shall. The Nightbringer is T11.
Yes.
Four up invuln save.
Yes.
Feel No Pain 5 up.
Yes.
Deadly Demise D6.
And half's damage.
Half's damage.
Okay. And Illuminator?
Illuminosarius. You can't shoot him, so it doesn't matter.
All right. I'm just wondering for the breaches.
Oh, for the breaches.
Yeah.
T9? No, 9 wounds. T8.
Okay.
4 up, feel no pain.
Okay.
4 up, invuln.
Okay. All right. So, look, let's shoot the other broadside at the back here.
There?
Yeah, that's probably wise.
Mm-hmm.
Two
which,
shots.
Which one?
You know what? Honor or glory? We're going into this guy.
Excellent.
Two shots. I hit you one time.
Yay.
It's not enough to do anything. That is devastating wounds, though.
Okay. How much damage?
Four
damage. So two damage. Let me feel no pain.
Yeah.
Two damage.
Well done, everyone. Let's go next with the Piranha. He shot both of his Hunter Seekers already,
mm-hmm.
so he will just shoot his Fusion Blaster into the Scarabs.
What?
He misses.
Not this guy.
No, he's too far away. Let's go with the Devilfish.
Yes.
Is this one shot at Seeker missiles, Dan? I need counters.
No.
Okay.
You advance with both the Devilfishes.
All right. I didn't advance this turn.
Last
but
turn.
Yes, you're absolutely right. So he's never actually shot before.
Mm.
He does have two Seeker missiles.
Ooh.
The accelerator burst cannon and two Seeker missiles into the guy right in front of him.
Fabulous, the Technomancer.
Yes. Four shots from the accelerator burst cannon. We're going to hit you on fours. Lovely. No exploding sixes this turn. Strength six.
T5, I think.
So two wounds, most likely.
Most likely.
No AP.
No AP. He doesn't get a FUMP anymore because he's no longer leading a unit. Great. That model's in a unit. He has, T4. Wow. He's got even worse. Four wounds.
Yep.
So how much?
No AP.
No
just
AP.
Your save.
Just my save. Four up. Oh dear. Nope. How much damage?
One each.
One each. He's down to two.
So now we've got two Seeker missiles into him.
Cool.
Come on, big boy. Both of those missed. Great. Well done, everyone.
Excellent.
Pants. We're going to have to charge him.
Tank shot.
Yeah, of course. What else have we got, Dan?
That has shot.
We've got the breaches and we've got the crises.
Yes.
All right, let's go with the breaches. Mm-hmm. Let's go with the breaches. I should have kept them back for another turn.
Nightbringer?
We're going to come back in a second because there's a lot of dice to roll for the breaches.
Yep.
And equally, there's a huge amount of dice to roll for the cyclic ion blaster crisis squad.
Let's
go. We're going to be shooting over here as well. So we're going to come back in a second and Dan's going to make a lot of saves.
Yes.
That's what we're going to come back for. All right. See you then. Okay. We've had a shooting phase. We have done some things that you may not well have seen. The breaches did shoot and they did 6 wounds to the Nightbringer. I popped a CP for the extra one. +1 to wound because you were within 9 inches. Mm-hmm. Very nice. Over there, the Crisis, 2 of the Crisis suits shot with hazardous.
And killed the
And they did Lord. Kill the Scorpec Lord. Ooh. I'm going to have to roll the hazardous checks in a second. Mm. All of the rest of the Crisis suits, we've still got to do the Commander in a second, rolled an awful lot of dice. We ended up with 26 exploding sixes because of the spot. 5s to wound into the Void Dragon. These are Daniel's 4 up invulnerable saves. We didn't overcharge because there was literally no point. The maths did not work in our favour. Yes, and it still didn't work in our favour. He halves damage, so there's a... Anyway, it was a risk. All right. That many wounds, Dan. And you got a thump.
5 up thumps. So he takes 5 wounds.
Crikey. That wasn't very good, was it? I bet you're glad we saved you all of that time.
Yes.
The Crisis Commander is going to shoot you now. We'll move all of these out of the way until next turn where I won't... Well, I've got another Crisis squad that are going to come down at some point with Farsight. Mm-hmm. Oh, dear. He's angry now. He's destroying things. I'm going to be in trouble later. He's going to shoot you down.
Mm-hmm.
And he's going to go with his Cyclic Iron Blasters as well. Mm-hmm. Not overcharging because there's no point. He's going to hit you on 2s with a reroll. I am going to choose to reroll all of these.
To try and get 6s.
To try and get some 6s. Didn't really work, but we are adding 4 more into the pot. These will wind you on 5s.
Mm-hmm.
Now we can do about it. 1, 2, 3. 3 saves, please, Daniel, on all your right. 4-up invuln. 2 go through.
5-up thumps.
1 more damage. Crikey, that was hard work. Whoa, we got a thing left to shoot with.
Mm-hmm.
He has shot, I think we did that on camera. We got the other devilfish who's going to shoot into the silly
mm-hmm.
Grim Reaper.
Yes.
He's got 4 shots with his burst cannon. Mm-hmm. He's going to hit you on 4s. Good. And he's probably going to wound you. He's strength 6 actually on this, so it'll be 5s. 1. No AP. Hey.
Goes through.
1 damage.
Thump. No.
Fair. 2 Hunter Seeker missiles.
Mm-hmm.
1 hits.
3s.
1 wounds. Minus loads. You're invuln.
He's good.
Good. All right. That was my shooting phase, Dan.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm.
Combat towel?
Yeah, combat towel. We're going to go for a charge.
Yeah.
We're going to charge the devilfish into this chap.
Yes.
We're going to call the tank shock.
Oh, yeah.
So we don't fail this charge.
Here comes the...
No, oh, look at that. We do not fail that charge. Shall we see if we tank you?
Probably.
So, what is it? Strength 6, I think, on his... He's strength 6 on his
plus
armoured hull. Plus 2, because we're more than
out.
You. 5s and 6s.
Oh, yeah.
2. Otherwise, it will be combat. We got 1.
Combat!
1 wound there, Daniel. 1 mortal wound.
Mm-hmm.
Now we're going to smack you. I hope you're ready.
Oh, yes.
I hope you're very ready. He's got 3 attacks. Combat town.
Combat
town. He's going to hit you on 5s. Ooh,
hits
he
twice.
Hits you twice. Strength 6. It's going to wound you on 2.
3s.
That's 1 wound. That's all you need.
He's okay.
Pants. He's going to smack me back.
He's going to hit you back with his Staff of Light. 2 attacks. Hitting you on 4s. No. Good.
Good. I might look at the replay later. It won't affect the rest of the game because I completely forgot about my exploding sixes with my shots. Don't think it would have made a difference.
You got 1.
Should we roll it?
No exploding sixes on turn 2.
You're absolutely right. Thank you. Thought it was turn three. Cool. That's it, man. That's my turn.
Cool.
That sort of worked.
You did.
Sort of.
Yeah, so you got your assassination points.
I got one character that I killed, so I'm getting... Oh, it's still 5 EP for assassinate at the end of my turn. And then investigate signals I just did on one corner. And it was a bit pants, really. Mm-hmm. I should have probably just discarded that one and gone for aggressive tau. So yeah. We did scan one, so we got 2 victory points for that.
Okay, so to finish off the turn, at the end of the fight phase, my Catan Shard drains life.
Does he have to be in combat for this, or is it just
nope,
end of the fight
phase? Nope, it just says at the end of the fight phase.
Cool.
So we have one unit within six.
Yes.
He still hasn't moved, and he still hasn't moved. So I think...
retreated out, but I think you're within six.
Within six, yep. So let's try those guys. They take D3 mortal wounds for 2.
These chaps. Or these ones.
Those chaps.
Okay.
Then the big unit take nothing.
Good.
The devil fish takes nothing.
Good.
Cool.
All right. Dan.
Yes.
It's your turn.
It's my turn.
You're getting a VP. CP.
Draw some things. So we've got area denial, defend stronghold, and no prisoners.
Yes. Those are... really good picks. Defend stronghold is your objective marker.
Yeah, so we'll probably take that one. It's not a lot of VP for
it. But it is a nice one.
But it is the one that I can achieve. Area denial.
Would be center of the battlefield.
And there are no enemy units, so... at the end of my turn.
End of your turn.
I mean, even if I am within 3, which I will still be,
yeah.
I get 3 VP, so I could... So we're going to go aggressive, because why not? We're going to discard defense stronghold.
Wow.
Because at the end of my turn, I am fairly confident that I'll be getting 3 regardless from that. And no prisoners, 2 VP for each unit I destroy. Probably won't destroy any. Probably should have just stuck with defense stronghold.
No prisoners. It's fun. You are, though, scoring, what's that,
some
3?
Primary. 3 for primaries there. And
3
I'll be scoring
plus
6.
3.
Nine points in total.
Yes.
For primaries.
Whew. Well, there's still a lot of killing left on the board.
Yes.
Let's have a look at movement and see where we are afterwards.
Let's command phase and movement and we go.
All right. Oh, do you have anything to reanimate before we come back?
We'll do that in the command phase.
Sure.
Yeah.
All right. See you in a second.
Because I have a lot.
All right.
Movement phase.
Yeah.
At the end of the movement phase, I've moved my Cryptech Technomancer there, who is going to give D3 wounds back to the Nightbringer for 3.
Lovely. Don't like these Catans. All right. Now, he was battle-shocked. He did retreat out of combat with the Devilfish, but he did pass his desperate breakout test.
Because he's a bit of a hero.
Yeah.
Then a little
Overwatch would have been delicious with those breaches, but Daniel was very smart and just moved him slightly out of the way.
Yes, so he's hiding in behind some cover.
Very true.
Then no movement there. We've moved our Scarabs into position for... one or two charges. We'll find out what they do later. Mm-hmm. Depends if this whole charge scenario goes off. And then we've also moved up the Shard of the Dragon, Void Dragon, and also brought on some Immortals.
Yes.
Yeah, so let's see what they can do here.
Yes.
So, first but foremost, let's do some shooting. We're going to... So we can shoot with these two fine... young upstanding gentleman here.
They're not upstanding, Dan. They're up hovering.
Up hovering.
Yeah.
This is a very good point. Sorry, what an idiot.
Come on. Who are they shooting into?
They are going to shoot at this unit of crisis suits.
Crises. Okay.
So they are hitting you on 2.
Just, sorry, Dan.
Yeah.
Quickly. Sorry, I'm so sorry. I'm just thinking if I stim injectors this unit to give a fill 4 up, 6 up, feel no pain for the rest of this. You're going to be shooting a lot into them, if we're completely honest. Like a lot into them, and it might well make sense.
Mm-hmm.
But then it would mean that I don't get to do cool strats.
Cool, but still.
No. Go on.
Okay, so we're going to shoot our 2 shots into them, hitting you on 2s. Wounding you on 2s because it is strength 14.
Yes.
And that is -4 to your armor, so it goes on to your invuln.
4 up. First one. Failed. Second one. Passes.
So one dead because it's six damage.
Okay.
I believe they're six wounds each.
Ooh, what are they? They're four base.
Plus two shield drones.
Plus two shield drones. They're four base plus two shield drones. You've taken out a guy.
Yay. Then we will shoot the immortals into them. Next.
Yours.
We've got lethal hits. We are hitting you on threes, because it's no longer twos, because I'm not using the right thing.
Yes.
So two shots each, 10 shots. And you're not within range of an objective marker, so no rerolls. So I do reroll ones. No ones. Rolled a few twos.
Aye.
Hit you six of the times. We are strength five, so wounding you on fives. We got one at minus one.
Lovely. We're okay.
You're okay. Then let's use the Shard of the Void Dragon coming at you.
Coming at you.
They are vehicles, I believe, correct?
Let me check. Crisis suits are vehicles.
So we have the Spear of the Void Dragon.
Are you very good against vehicles, Dan?
Very good against vehicles. Actually, because your ghost kills a vehicle, isn't he?
Yes.
And the Void Dragon is within 12, so he can shoot him, and he will. So he's going to use the Spear of the Void Dragon, one shot, hitting you on twos. Wounding on twos is anti-vehicle two up.
Lovely.
Minus three to your armor on your ghost kill.
Okay, and the damage?
Damage is D6 plus two.
Okay, so you're not going to like this, Dan.
Yeah.
So it's fine.
Yeah.
Wait, was it minus two?
Minus two, yes.
Wait, we got a two up save base?
Probably, usually.
And it's, he does have stealth, so it would have been
minus three.
So it would have been, yeah.
So see if he has an inbound.
Yeah, I did forget as well that he was minus one to hit, because he's got stealth, but it's fine.
Yeah, I rolled quite well.
Okay, so no, it does go through. We will use one of his two Guardian drones to negate that damage to zero.
Excellent. Cool. We also have a Voltaic Storm. D6 plus three shots. May as well go at the Ghost Kill. We'll try and do some damage to your Crisis Suits. So, this is D6 plus three shots. Blast, you still have more than five.
Yes.
So we are hitting you with nine shots. 10 because of blast. Hitting you on twos. These are sustained two. I've got my own tail.
You do, it's very
three.
True.
That is a boggled, so we'll roll that one. Cool, that still gets you.
So you got one miss.
One miss, but then we get three extras on top. Strength 77?
Five. Are you shooting the Crisis Squad?
Shooting the Crisis Suits.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, sorry, T5.
T5, oh. So we are wounding you on threes. That is that many at minus one.
Okay. Yeah. Sorry. Mm-hmm. Crisis Suits. I've never actually had to deal with their base save. Base save three, so it's four ups. How much damage each?
Two damage each.
Oh dear. 2, 4, 6 kills a guy, and 2, 4 on the next one. Yay. So one goes down to two, one guy's dead.
We are also going to use our matter absorption on the ghost kill. On a two up, you receive D3 mortal wounds. That's a two. You receive three mortal wounds, okay. And the Catan Shard of the Void Dragon regains that many wounds.
Okay.
Nice.
Did you have to declare that with any other shots?
No, just it's an ability.
All right. Cool.
So that is that bunch of shots. Ooh. I did say I was shooting all of these into them.
Yeah.
I forgot to do the Plasmancer. So the Plasmancer has three shots. Hits you two of the times because we cannot take court.
Very nice.
Strength seven, so threes.
Yeah.
Minus three.
And how much damage?
It doesn't matter because it goes to the four. Doesn't matter.
Okay. How many mortal wounds to the ghost kill?
Three.
Cool. All right. Where you go next, Dan?
When we're going to shoot the Eldritch Lance from Illuminor Zarias. He is going to fire that into your devilfish.
Okay. Bring it.
Three shots, hitting you on threes. Strength nine, T more, so five, I assume. Two. Minus three to your armor.
Okay. So six or a five. Six. One save.
It's three damage.
Okay. Down to seven.
We are then going to use the Gaze of Death. D3 shots, and we're going to declare that into... Don't like him. The Devilfish. One shot. Hits you on a two.
Good.
We're going to CP reroll that.
Wow. Yep, that's about right.
Good. That's about right. That's all his shooting. He can't shoot because he ran away. We are then going to shoot. First of all, we're going to shoot this Cannot Tech Destroyer. Cannot Tech Doomstalker into that.
This broadside?
The broadside over there.
At the back.
The back there.
Cool.
He will give it a cover. D6 plus one shots. Three. Hits you on threes, but re-rolling all shots.
Does he just have an innate re-roll?
Because of my Canoptic Court within my deployment zone.
Cool.
So that hits you all the times.
New army rule.
New army rules. Then does it have dev wounds or anything like that? Just quickly checking. No, blast heavy. No, none of that. So all these hits, strength 14.
Against that one. Yes, it'll be twos.
Twos. Good. And I've already done my CP reroll.
Minus.
Three to your invuln.
They don't have an invuln against normal, but he will get cover, so it'll be four up save. One goes through.
Hmm. One goes through, three damage.
Cool.
We are going to shoot the other one at your broadside with three wounds left.
Mm-hmm.
D6 plus one shots. Get ready for you to save all of these again.
Yes, sir.
He has a little bit of cover anyway, so we're hitting you on threes, re-rolling. Hit you that many times, wound you on twos. Minus three to your armor.
Into that little chap.
That little chap there.
Cool, so minus three, four up saves. Mm-hmm. He is very much dead.
He's very much dead.
Does he explode?
No.
All right.
Then I think that is all the shooting that I have.
Yes. Have you got some charges, Dan?
I do have some charges to do. We're going to start with the one that matters. Turn Shard of the Void Dragon into your Crisis Suits. CP reroll. We're in.
He's in.
He's going to go here.
Okay.
Nice. We're going to charge with Illuminor Zarias into your breaches.
We're going to pop a CP and get back in the tank.
Oh.
So you can declare a different target.
We're going to declare the tank then.
Cool. Do you want to roll it again?
Do I have to roll it again?
Well, you should have rolled it when he said he was going to be. It's fine. He's into the tank.
He's into the tank. Right, we'll roll. 5 inches. I think we don't make it because it was 11 before.
No, mate, just get in. No, Dan, just put him in there.
Yeah. Ooh. Bosh. We will charge with the Nightbringer.
Into
the Devilfish.
Okay.
He doesn't make it.
No.
We will charge with this unit of Scarabs into the lone Fireblade. Very
that'll
much
make it.
In, I think.
Yeah, 9 inches.
Because he can move through his own people, yes. How many wounds has Catray Fireblade got again?
Like three? I wouldn't worry too much, Dan. Three.
Three. Fabulous.
Oh, he has two shields drones with him, which is quite nice. I think he gets two. He might get one. He might get none. Mm. He gets two shield drones. Lovely.
We are then going to charge the other unit of Scarabs into the Suicide Piranha. They're in.
Lovely.
Where are they? Oh, there.
Cool.
Cool. Right. Start of the fight phase.
Yeah.
We are going to explode a unit of one base from each of the Scarabs. So firstly, against the Piranha, one or two up. Okay, so one base dies, nothing happens. And then against Cadre Fireblade, you take D3 mortal wounds.
One. Down to four after losing a shield drone. Okay.
Okay, then let's do some other hittings. We're going to start with the Void Dragon.
Yes, let's see how much damage he can do.
Melee weapons. Ooh, extra attack. So we're going to start with using his Canoptech tail blades.
Yes.
Six attacks, hitting you on twos.
Lovely.
Hits you all the times. Then wounding you on threes because he's strength six.
Yes.
So that is three. Minus one to your armor, so fours.
We'll go through.
Three damage.
All right, that chap is dead, and another one is down to five, effectively.
Yay.
Next attacks.
Next attacks. We're then, because they're vehicles, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so we're going to, we're going to go with the Spear of the Void Dragon, the strike version. So we've got five attacks hitting you on twos. All hit. Anti-vehicle, two up.
So twos.
We're going to CP reroll this. I've got a bunch of CP.
I haven't used one for the fight phase. Okay.
One for the fight phase, yes. So, minus three to your armor, doesn't matter, goes to the four up invuln. That's a lot of four ups.
Two go through.
D6 plus two damage each, so I'll roll them one at a time.
Yeah. Kills a guy.
Kills a guy. Do they explode?
No.
Ah, boo.
All right.
All right.
Next ones.
We will then do the attacks from the scarabs into your
cadre.
Let me see if they've lost attacks or anything since the update. Six attacks, still lethal hits, hitting you on fives. One, two, three, five, six. Three lethals.
Crikey. It's enough to do him in. The poor Fireblade.
Then strength two. So
it will be fives.
Four.
That's as many wounds as he has, Dan.
Minus six?
That's very good for a scarab. He is probably all right with some of those. He's got a four up save. He takes a wound. He's been a bit of a legend, hasn't he?
Yeah, he is a bit of a legend. The other scarabs are going to hit you.
Yes. Piranha.
Against Piranha. Fishing for sixes. That was a six.
I'll give you that.
We hit with none of the others.
Cool. We are okay.
Okay. And that leaves just the Illuminor Zarias.
Oh, yes.
Go with the rubber sacks first. Hitting you on threes. Wounding you on... Actually, what's your toughness? Because it's strength six for these.
I'm T9 on a devilfish.
So, nothing.
Fives.
Then the other attacks from his Eldritch Lance, hitting you on threes. Wounding on fours because he's strength nine.
Lovely.
One, minus three to your armor.
Okay. Nope.
Three damage.
All right, he's down to four.
Yay. Now you get your attacks back.
Well, he's going to run you over, Dan. I hope you're ready for this.
I'm ready for this.
I hope you are. It's going to be incredibly impressive. As we know, combat tower is the way to go.
The best.
Yeah. So he's got a mighty three attacks.
Mm-hmm.
Hitting on fives. Oh, that's okay.
Yes.
It's off the board. That's okay. Cool.
That's done.
The Cadre Fireblade, though.
Here he is, the mightiest.
Here he is. You've only got like five wounds in each of those stupid scarab swarms, haven't you?
Not really four.
Three attacks. Hitting you on fours. He's not that angry. Strength three. Does wound.
He is angry.
No AP.
Six up save.
No. One damage. And then over here, we've got a combat piranha, which is even better.
Mm-hmm.
Two attacks on this one. Hit you once. Mm-hmm. Strength four.
So twos.
Yes. No AP, obviously.
One damage.
Great. Combat tower. One damage.
And then you've got your crisis suits and your commander with his sword.
Yeah. He doesn't have a sword, that one.
Oh.
He's not Farsight. I think they're all the same, actually, all the same weapon profile. So he's got three attacks that hit you on fours, strength five, and they've got three attacks that hit you on fives. Let's roll them separately. Hmm. The commander. Mm-hmm. He hits you
all
three times. He is strength five.
So sixes.
He wounds you one time.
Mm-hmm. Any minus?
Of course not.
Four up save. Five up thump.
Yes, does a damage. And then the dude next to him hits on fives. Nothing.
Cool.
So, end of your turn, Daniel.
Oh, you have to hit me with your devilfish as well.
I did that one. If I didn't, let's do it. No. Good.
Cool.
Okay, Dan, scores on the doors at the end of your turn.
Did I destroy any units? No.
No.
So nothing for no prisoners. Area denial, though.
Yes, you are scoring the max on.
Yes.
Because I'm not within six.
Yes.
Cool. So how many points on that one, mate?
Oh, so just to finish off, before we do that, so that is 5 points from that.
Yep.
However, I do also roll dice for everyone within six of him, which is only one guy now, because I don't think that devilfish has been in there. On a four up, he takes D3 mortal wounds.
Okay.
One.
End of every fight phase, yeah?
End of every fight. End every fight phase.
Nice.
Of the fight phase.
Cool. So 5 points on the secondaries for that. Tom, what are the scores on the doors after turn two?
20 to the power, 17 to the Necron.
Told you, man, it's very close. It's very close.
It is, well. Do I keep this for a potential five next turn, or do I take a CP? Because I have them down to one, I think. I don't really use them that much. Anyway, aerial denial is scored, no prisoners. We'll keep it. Yeah, there's a potential we could kill something next turn. Yeah, why not?
Sweet. Let's move on into Tau turn three then.
Mm-hmm.
We are getting 3, 6, 9 for the primary.
Mm-hmm.
Secondary wise, engage on all fronts, cleanse, no prisoners. We're going to get rid of cleanse because it's not that type of game today.
No.
We're going to go for engage on all fronts and we're going to go for no prisoners.
Yep.
So 2 victory points for every unit killed. Let's do a couple of battle shocks. Mm-hmm. Let's do one for the devilfish. He's all right. And let's do one for the Cadre Fireblade. He's already passed. What? No, he hasn't. Let's do one for him. He's all right. And then let's do one for the Crisis Suits and the Commander. They are probably okay on a 6.
Yeah.
Yes. Nope. No, they're not.
Commander?
Is 7.
Ooh.
Crisis Suits are 7 as well.
Oh.
We're probably going to have to... Oh, dear. I need to drop something else down, but he is a vehicle or a monster. I might actually just leave him to it completely. That's okay. That's okay. They got Batshock. All right. All right. Mm-hmm. Let's do some movement, see what we can do, and come back in a second. Yeah. Sticky right now. There's an awful lot stuck.
Yes.
And it's like, I mean, it's what Necrons do. It's like wading through treacle. So we've got to see if we can break the back of it this turn. In the movement phase, we did drop down with Farsight and his Crisis over here. Mm-hmm. Move the stealth squads just up onto here so we can get some spotting targets. Kept the broadsides where they were because we've got enough targets knocking about. Stayed in combat over there. We did fail the battle shock, so if we pulled out, there's a risk that the models would die, and that wouldn't be very fun. Pulled the Ghost Keel over to just secure that objective and get some shots in at the Immortals. Now we got some shooting to do. Well, actually, we got some spotting to declare.
Ooh.
So we might as well spot these stealth suits into... you know what? I'm probably going to split my shots. The stat line on them down there, T8?
They are T... something.
Good.
I think it's T8. Let's go with T8 for now. You're trying to figure out whether to overcharge or not.
Yes.
That's the question there. T8, yes.
Okay. So we will be wounding on 4s. It could be quite nice to get a 1 to reroll, so... Yeah, okay. We'll give... Ooh, we're probably going to split it anyway. Hmm. We'll come back to that.
Split fine never works, Will.
Yeah, I know. So, like, he's got the better feel no pain. He doesn't.
Yes.
So, this unit of Tetras are going to spot for this unit of Breachers. This Devilfish might as well spot that unit of Immortals for the Ghost Keel, because
mm-hmm.
we're going to shoot there anyway. I'm probably going to end up shooting both of my broadsides into this guy, I think.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll probably spot the stealth suits over here for that broadside.
Mm-hmm.
And let's get to it. Oh, the last one to spot. Just the double exploding sixes is good. I think I can probably take out both of them with enough shots.
Or these?
Yeah.
Don't know if you can see. You can see with one of them.
We can, because it's obscuring up to here.
Yeah, of course, that's light. Yeah.
Yep. Cool. So let's get on with some shooting. We'll start with the broadsides and see what we can do. Mm-hmm. This broadside's going to shoot here.
Yes.
2 shots from his big gun.
Oh,
hits on
yes.
twos.
One dev, one nothing.
Well, one... No, it's Dev Wounds.
But re-rolling because of spotting.
He was spotted by here, which is on the wounds, not on anything else. But he has been spotted, so it's three hits.
Yes. One's Dev... so you don't need to roll for it?
No, sorry. Dev Wounds, not lethal hits.
Ah, yeah.
So it's a wound. That is two Dev Wounds and one save at minus four.
Four up. New.
So 3d6 plus one.
Yep.
And then your feel no pains.
Yes.
3d6 plus three, effectively.
Yes.
8, 16. Oh, it's plus one on each, isn't it? Six. Two. Good. 14. Feel no pains, Dan. Hmm.
But to save the pain of everyone watching, we'll just roll this twice. I know I should roll them one at a time, but it is what it is. That is five, so I have three wounds left.
Can we take out the Illuminator? Can we extinguish the illumination?
Two wounds left.
Well, do them one at a time, and that's what happens. One wound left. Okay. Next, then, is going to be this devilfish that's going to shoot into him.
Ooh.
From the... It's just pitter-patter, but I've got to do a wound. Mm-hmm. Come on. Legendary devilfish. Four shots. He hits you all of the times.
Ooh.
Strength six. Toughness more. Fives. Wire. Two wounds down. No AP.
No AP. He's all right.
He's all right. Okay, that's that devilfish. Let's try with the marksman. Three shots. Heavy, so it's twos. Good. Two hits.
Doesn't he have a special thing?
He does, but only if he's been spotted, and he hasn't. So that is, though, two wounds, Dan.
Mm-hmm.
And that is minus one.
Three up save. How much damage?
Two damage. Fine.
Not fine.
He goes down. We killed a guy. Hey. That means my breaches are free.
Yes.
Come on, breaches. We'll do them after. Mm-hmm. Let's shoot with the broadside that wasn't guided into your stupid Nightbringer and mm-hmm. see if we can do any pitter-patter. Two shots, Dan.
Yep.
One hit. One wound. Minus lots, so it'll be your invuln. Cole, d6 plus one damage.
Ooh.
Four, six. Six, three, because you half damage.
Yep. Oh, yes. Thank you for reminding me.
And then your fumps.
Fumps. Two.
Two damage. All right. Now we're getting somewhere. This devilfish shooting into this guy to save me a tank shot later.
Okay.
We hit you three of the times, but we do get an extra one because it's turn three, and Tau become alive in turn three.
Yes.
That is two wounds.
Two wounds, no strength six.
Yep.
Ooh, no AP. Four up save.
We're going to have to charge you.
Come on, one of these.
Fine, we'll charge you. We'll do it in combat. However, my Tetras are actually going to be able to shoot for the first time, as long as you're within 30. And we might as well shoot them. They're going to be at minus one. Ooh, yes, we're going to be at minus one. Because we spotted for a different unit.
Yeah.
But let's try it, man. We got to do a wound.
Exactly.
Let's find out.
There's always a chance.
Tetras, they've got one shot each. They can hit you on fives.
One hit, that's all you need.
Strength five. No AP.
Come on. He's all right.
Okay. What have we not shot with? We haven't shot with the crisis suits over there.
In combat?
Yeah, you're a monster.
I think I am, yeah.
Or a vehicle.
Yeah, I am a monster.
Yeah. It's going to be minus one to hit you, I guess, because we're shooting into combat.
Yes, I'm not Titanic or anything.
No. So these are the normal dude.
Yep, nine shots.
Nine shots. We're overcharging because why not? Oh, no, it literally makes no difference because you've got a four-up filner pain.
Yeah, an inbound, yeah.
So he hits you not that many of the times because we're at minus one,
yeah.
But we do get three more.
Yes. Six more.
No, I'm not guided.
Yes.
Right?
Yes. Yeah, because you're not guided, yeah.
And then these will be fives. One.
He's all right.
Cool. And then the 9 from the commander should be rerolling once, but mattered. He's going to hit you on 3s. He is going to reroll once for himself. Mm-hmm. Cool.
He and then gets that is four extra.
That's all right, isn't it?
Yeah.
Cool. So he is going to win on 5s. Obvs.
That's quite good.
3, 4, 5 saves to make, please, Daniel, at -1.
5 up, thump.
Good. Absolutely nothing. Mm. Let's shoot with the ghost kill, who has been spotted by a devil fish. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We're going to overcharge. We're going to shoot into the immortals.
Ooh.
Oh, do we shoot into the... Oh, he got spotted into the immortals, so we might as well. Mm. 6. Hit you
that many times,
but yeah, he doesn't hit on... No, he hits on 4s normally, so it'll be 3s, but we do get 2 extras because it's turn 3. Strength, 8.
T, 5, so 3s.
Oh dear, just 3 at -2.
5 ups. How much damage?
They are 3 each.
3 each, 3 dead immortals.
Then we got a twin heavy flamer. D6. 4, 3. That was so close to the 6. Strength 4, so it'll probably be 5.
Yep.
But it is twin linked.
So re-roll.
No, just 1. No AP. All dead. Right, 1 more.
How much damage?
Just 1.
Just 1. Oh, I think they're 2 wounds. Let me just double check. Because they might be super special. No, they're 1 wound. Ignore me.
Nice.
He dies.
All right, we've got Breachers left to shoot with and we've got the big new Crisis Squad left to shoot with. Just so you guys know, the Breachers are going to plug everything into this horrible death man.
Sure. We will.
Crisis suits are probably going to split between those two Canoptic Doomstalkers. Get greedy, see if it pays off. We will come back in a second because there's a lot of dice to roll.
Oh, yes.
So, Daniel, that was quite a good shooting phase. Turns out you do wait until turn 3 for the Tau because yes. They get an awful lot better.
Exactly.
We did, with this Breacher Squad popping a CP, yes, we killed Death itself.
Catan Shard of the Nightbringer is gone.
Popped CP for a +1 to wound, mm-hmm. Did get spotted. You were near an objective, so we were re-rolling all our wounds. Mm-hmm. We did 17 damage to him after 4 up bumps and 4 up whatever. It was quite good.
Yes.
Over here...
You want me to roll these saves?
We just want to say... Yes.
Yes.
Yes. This big blob over here shots, split their shots effectively. Farsight did 3 wounds.
Yep. And Farsight already did 3 wounds to 1. And then you got 10 hits on each of the Doomstalkers.
10 wounds on each of them. Everything was hazardous, so I could kill myself after this.
I need to save a lot of these. So that is, first Doomstalker is down.
Does he explode?
Let's find out.
Yes!
So he's going to do some wounds to a friend.
3
wounds to his friend.
He already took 3 wounds from before.
Yeah.
So now you've got 10 saves to make. He's taken 6 wounds.
He's dead. So he doesn't explode. But with that, I think we can probably say the Tower won.
That was the turn that we needed to break the back of what was going on.
Yep.
We'll get quite a bit. Well, we'll get no prisoners for 5. We'll get engaged in all fronts just for the 3, but yep. I think...
So it would be 100 points for the Tau?
No, we wouldn't get to 100 down because the first 2 turns we did terrible. We did not great, and you did manage to block quite a lot. I think parking a Catan on each of the objectives is probably the way to play Necrons.
Yes.
It just takes so much killing. Mm. It takes so much killing. Yes. Unless you got the hero Breachers that we all love and cherish.
Well, it shows D1 damage is the way to do it, though, against those Nazis.
Damage
1
is the way to do it.
So, like the Eldar Incarn, the Eldar Incarnate?
Incarn, the Avatar.
Avatar of Kane, that's the one. Yeah, the Incarn and the Avatar of Kane. That's the way to do it. Breachers, that's the way we go. Thoroughly wiped all over the floor, so well played.
Look, whenever we play a new army mm-hmm. or we play a new codex, it goes terribly wrong. But that's because we're learning how to be better.
Yes.
And we'll see how the Necrons do next time. That is the first Tau win in forever. Maybe ever. Mm-hmm. Maybe ever at 2K, so that's a little bit exciting. Still the Kill Chris sign, because still no one has taken Chris off of his Astra Militarum pedestal.
Still going strong.
Still going strong. Thank you so much for watching.
Yep.
Thank you, Daniel, for playing. And in very... is it magnanimous?
Magnanimous.
In slight defeat?
Maybe. We'll get the salt grinder out to see.
We will get the salt. We'll get the salt level.
And to see on the replay.
Up and down through the game, as is standard.
Yeah.
Thank you all for watching. Do hit us up with a little subscribe if you like what we're doing. Yeah. Give us a like if you feel like Daniel should play the Necrons again and give it another go.
Yes.
Don't give us a dislike, because why would you do that?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Well. But give us a like if you want Daniel to play the Necrons again. Give us a comment if you want to see the Tau more on the channel, or if you want me to take stuff that isn't just Crisis Suits.
And more importantly, give us some comments if you want to see those beautiful-looking Tyranids on the channel, because we want to see those.
Dan just doesn't want to play Necrons anymore. We will see you on the next one. Thanks a lot.
See you on the next one. Thanks, guys. Bye.